As a teacher, I live by my to-do list and I love to customize it on PowerPoint for exactly what I need. Starting with a new PowerPoint presentation, click on the Design tab. We want to make this printable, so we're changing the page setup to 11 inches by 8.5 inches. Let's start by inserting a text box. Pick a nice bold font so that you can see it clearly. Not only can we choose whatever font we want, but we can also make the size a lot bigger. This font size is set to 80. If you have a color palette that you love, you can actually color match exactly by using the little eyedropper tool. Click on the little A and then choose more colors. That will bring up an eyedropper tool. Next, let's duplicate our text box, right click, format shape. Now click on text options. Here we're changing the outline to black and no color fill. It just gives it a nice look. Heading back to the panel, choose shapes. We're adding this rectangle, doing a white fill and a black outline. You can change the weight of the outline under weight. Let's insert another rectangle from shapes. This is going to be a little header. So again, just choosing white for my fill and then a heavier weight for the border. Clicking that small header, we can now change the color at the top where it says shape fill. Heading back to shapes, let's choose a circle. We can make the circle white on the inside with the shape fill and then a black outline. As you can see, there's so many ways to use shapes, which is so fun. So here we're just adding a line and you could change the width again and whatever color you want it to be. Looks like we're ready to group these together. Hold down the shift button while choosing your two shapes. Then right click and choose group. This is going to make it easy to duplicate, which is just Command D. Let's drag the mouse over all these shapes so we can save some time. Right click and choose group. Then we're going to hit Command D. If you want to customize more, click on those little headers and you can go back and change the colors. Let's insert another text box so we can type and make these a little more personal. Since this is my teacher to-do list, there's always something to purchase, to organize. The goal is to make this work for you. Going back into our shapes, inserting another rectangle. Again, you can customize this how you want it. I suggest keeping the weight the same, just so it all matches. I always like to leave a spot for important reminders. Heading back to the top panel, click on Insert and look for icons. These icon images are so fun. Let's add an email one. What I love about these is you can change the color to anything you want. Let's use a little card to remind us of all the errands we gotta do. Now just adding in a phone icon as a reminder to make some calls. Final step, adding in one more rectangle. Choosing no fill and picking a color that matches for a nice border. And there you have it, a printable to-do list made effortlessly with PowerPoint.